Josiah, where do you think the confidence level of this team is going into the tournament?
It's really high. I feel like it's winner go home time. We know that. And we know that in the locker room, we have everything that we need. We just got to go out there and get the job done in the first day.
What do you feel like you guys have learned without Zakai Zeigler, what you need to do?
Yeah, that we have to rely on each other a whole lot more. We don't have one like distinguished point guard. We're trying to do it by committee. And so we got to take that challenge on as a group with the guards. And, you know, we have to share the ball like he did, but we have to do it as a collective.
Besides, the network last night cited Zakai's absence as a reason as possibly why Tennessee won't advance in the tournament. Does that give you guys more motivation?
I mean, we have all the motivation we need. We know, we feel like we've been disrespected all year. Granted, we've had some tough games, had some tough losses, but we don't really listen to the outside noise. We have all the fuel, all the motivation that we need because we know we got to go down there and get the job done.
What has to happen for you all to go down there and get the job done and make a nice run in the tournament?
Well, simply put, we just got to score more points than the other team. But, you know, we have to be locked in. We know Louisiana is a really, really talented team. They got three really key good guys who can play in any league. They've got a great team, but those three guys in specific, especially Jordan Brown, you know, he's transferred around a little bit, but he's a former McDonald's All-American, a guy who can, I mean, he's shown that he can get the job done. So we just got to be locked in defensively and play as a unit, both offensively and defensively.
What stands out about Brown's game?
I haven't really watched a lot of film. We just got kind of, you know, some notes on him. I saw that he averages, like, he draws over five fouls a game. And so, you know, keeping our bigs out of foul trouble will be big. But I know that Coach Gainey said he recruited him when he was at Arizona. He said he's got game, he's talented, but I haven't really watched a lot of film on him yet.
Josiah, Jimmy had a great stat about your scoring.
Yeah, the last 13 games when you score more than 10 points, you're 7-0. When you don't, you're 1-5.
So in light of that, are you putting pressure on yourself to score? About your offense?
I mean, I feel like what my team needs is for me to be – wait, what was that stat?
When you score more than 10 points, you win.
Okay, got you. I know that for my team to put my team in a position to win, I know I have to be aggressive on both ends, but especially the offensive end, and get my shots and take good rhythm shots, not trying to really, you know, be too aggressive or over-aggressive, just letting the game come to me, and I feel like that's when I'm most comfortable. But, I mean, hopefully I can score the ball.
What's it been like watching Santi the past few games? Seems like he's just locked in at a different level right now offensively.
Yeah, it's been great. He's been, you know, I'd say really the one consistent guy throughout, you know, the entire year, really. He gets game plan for harder than anybody. So, I mean, his job is really tough. But just, you know, seeing the way he comes in and works each and every day, it shows and it makes you realize why he's playing so well in these games. And so we just got to follow suit. Santi's been a great leader for us all year, and I expect him to keep doing great things down in Orlando.
What have you learned being in NCAA tournaments over the past few years?
They're a lot of fun. They're a lot of fun, and there's no gimme games. Like there's no easy way, out. Every team is coming to win that tournament, the four team tournament that you're in. I've only been fortunate enough to win one, so I know it's really hard to make it out of that first weekend, and it's really tough to win the first game. So we know we got to be locked in, and that's just what, you know, us as older guys who have been there before and trying to, you know, get guys to understand that it's not going to be easy. I don't care if it's a team you haven't heard of, a big name team. All the teams are ready to play, and you gotta. It's win or go home time.
Rick mentioned that kind of playing back to back the other day was hard on your body with all the injuries you've been dealing with this season. How big do you think this week is going to be big for you, and then also kind of that day in between games if y'all are able to win?
Yeah, I think it'll be huge. I know I was a little fatigued going that second day just because, you know, I had worked my way back, but I'd never really done a back-to-back like that. So I'm not making any excuses, but it was definitely tough for me. But I'm excited for this week. We've had more days off, I feel like, in the last 3 days than we've had all year. My body feels great. I know everybody else. I'm speaking for everybody else when I know we're ready to go. We'll be ready by Thursday. And, you know, that day in between will be really big for us just to recover if we're fortunate enough to win that first game.
In these last few games without Zeigler, have you missed him more on the offensive end or the defensive end?
I say offensively because, And the games that we've lost, we've been right there in the end. And, you know, if you go back and watch film, in the end, the last four-minute games, the 4 minutes of the games, that's when Zakai would usually have the ball in his hands, doing a lot of pick-and-roll stuff. So it's just guys having to play different roles. And I was glad we were able to play an extra game down in Nashville just to, you know, keep to kind of find a groove with the lineup that we have. But I definitely say we've missed them on both ends, but definitely more on the offensive end.
Josiah, does that late tip bother you? Would you rather be one of these guys that like to get it out of the way early, or how do you guys feel about that? It
doesn't matter to me. I've been playing basketball. I played AAU. I played 4 games, 5 games in 1 day. I don't think it matters for me. I don't think it matters for the guys.
Josiah, Zakai Zeigler is one of the best in the nation on getting back on defense after an offensive miss. How hard is that to ingrain in your head when you're not used to doing that at the point guard position?
Yeah, it's tough because we're usually sending 4 guys to the glass, and the guys that we have running point right now within the starting lineup is me, Shaq, and Santi. And so sometimes we're thinking go to the glass, and that actually hurt us a couple of times against Missouri. They got some fast break points, and even in the Ole Miss game. So it's just, you know, guys learning a new role and, you know, having to get back on defense is something that we'll have to do against Louisiana.
Josiah, driving all the way to the lane, whether it's you or anyone else, how much would that help open things up for you if you guys are a threat to get to the rim?
Yeah, it opens everything up because obviously we're a great outside shooting team, but that can't be our first and only option. We have to get paint touches, and, you know, the percentages show that shots coming from inside to out are much higher than just shots going around the arc. And so that'll be big for us. We know we have guys that can do it, so we just got to go show it and get it done.
You talked about some defensive lapses here recently in crucial moments. How do you guys eliminate that moving forward?
Just be as disciplined as possible. Coach is always teaching, coaching us up on discipline. And, you know, that's really what comes down, what defensive lapses come down to, is just a lack of discipline. And so we just got to, you know, clean up those mistakes, and we'll put ourselves in a good position to win.
Two more.
You mentioned the high level of confidence. What are some of the specific things, or maybe even something you haven't mentioned, why you're confident in this team that can make it?
I just feel like, you know, ever since we got together over the summer, we've had one main goal, and that is to, you know, hoist that national championship trophy. And I know that everybody's will to win is at a high level. And I just have ultimate faith in my teammates. I know our coaches have ultimate faith in us, and it's not going to be easy, but I really see us doing big things down in the tournament.
You mentioned earlier about feeling disrespected. Do you think people have doubted this team a lot?
For sure. And I mean, some people say for good reason. When we're at our best, I feel like we're the best team in the country, but it's just being able to stay consistent in that, and we haven't done that all year. But we know when we play at our best, we play together. It's really tough to beat us.
Thank you, Joe. Thank you.